Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back for another episode of Let's Play The Legend of Zelda, The Minish Cap. I'm your host, Grandpa Armania, and on the previous episode, we finished the Fortress of Winds, only to find out there is no element here. In fact, the people who were previously occupying the Fortress of Winds took the element with them into the sky. So, unfortunately, we got a booty prize of the Ocarina of Wind. So, we're gonna go ahead and use that. And it plays a wonderful melody for us. And we can now fly all over Hyrule. Well, not completely all over, but you know, you guys get the gist. So we're one gonna go over here to the right, which is actually Lake Hylia. And it's here. Ah, so that's the mysterious mark we've been seeing is a wind crest. If you play the Ocarina of Time, Zephyr comes to pick you up and fly you away. That means we can have Zephyr carry us to any other wind crest we've seen. Are you following me, Link? Don't hurt your brain thinking about it. Just give it a try and you'll see what I'm talking about. Yeah. So what we want to do is shrink down to the size of a minuscule. I'm never going to get sick of that joke. And we want to talk to this Minish. Oh, a visitor, how rare. But you have found me, the wisest of the wisest of the wise. You what? You want to enter the Temple of Droplets? I've heard rumors that one Minish actually did find a way in long ago. That Minish is Elder Library. Really subtle, right? And he is in semi-retirement in the town library. The library should be opening soon, so perhaps you can go find him. Alright, and can we actually fuse Kinstones with him? Do I have a red? I don't have a red that fits his. Ah, well. Alright, so let's go ahead and go back to big size. And so now we're going to be doing just a few side quest things before we can actually get into the Temple of Droplets, which is the next place we have to go. So what we're going to do is go ahead and TP here to, the Hyrule Town. It's brain fart. And so we want to go ahead and go to the library. And apparently Elder Library is here, or library. I don't know how to pronounce it. I'd assume library, because that's like the most, it's like the most innocuous way to say it. And so we use the Cane of Pachi to flip that over and once again shrink, and we can go into here. And as you can see, there is some stuff leaving here, so we could just go in, and there is another Minish. And I tried flipping him upside down. All right, hey, this is no good at all. A human borrowed a book, and now none of us can get back to the Elder. How will he get all alone? How will he get by all alone? I'm so worried. I'm sure the librarian knows somewhere about where those books went. But there's nothing we Minish can do about it. Ugh. Alright, well, let's just climb up here. There is another Minish up here. And let's see what he's got to say. We can't get up the shelf because some human checked out the book. But at least we don't have to worry. We don't have to listen to Elder Librarians. Boring old stories. Alright, let's see. Can I fuse with him? Yeah! Alright, what do we get for fusing with the library Minish? Okay, so in the Minish Woods, there is a treasure chest. Cool. So, maybe we'll get that, maybe not. I tend to have a bad memory when it comes to these things, guys, if you haven't noticed. Oh, whoops, accidentally talked to him. I meant to roll, because that's how I roll. Alright, so let's go ahead and get on out and get out here. And once again, become lifelike, or life-size, or, well, that's actually really weird if you think about it. Like, lifelike, life-size, it's like, you know, what's the difference, man? We're all life. Well, except the objects, that wouldn't be life. You can actually ram into these masks, but you know, I don't think they give anything. Yeah, oh, nice, that gave me 5 rupees, and 5 rupees is nice. Alright, let's talk to you! Welcome to the library! Say, aren't you Smith's grandson, Link? Hmm? The books missing from the bookshelf on the second floor? Yes, they've been checked out for quite a while. They're very overdue. Take a Hyrulean bestiary, for example. Been gone for ages. Checked out by a girl with a cat. She said she had a new cat at her house. Want to learn more about it, she did. Hmm, I see. Okay, so unfortunately what this means is we're gonna have to say goodbye to Mr. Fairy. Trust me when I say this, because what you want to do is go ahead and get water in the bottle. or water in our bottle, I should say. So let's go ahead and go down here. So we now get to be Link the Librarian. Or, well, actually more so Link the Book Collector, but let's go in here. And hey, I believe this is the woman, huh? A book from the library? A Hyrulean Bestiary? Is that the one? Yeah, I checked it out a while ago. You came all this way to get it? Wow, you're one dedicated librarian. But I don't know how to tell you this. It's back at my house. Would you mind going there to get it? I can't leave right now, see? We can trade fuse. We can fuse kinstones. I don't know why I keep thinking trade, but we can fuse kinstones with you. So what do you give us, Julietta? Julietta, the overdue bookkeeper. And you are going to give us a treasure chest. Oh, nice. Cool. Okay. What did your boyfriend have to say?
They say the king's been weird lately. That doesn't really have anything to... Wait.
Oh, no! Doesn't really have anything to do with our love. Mm. Alright, so what you're supposed to do is put that water out. Put that fire out. Wow, I am just on top of my talking game today. I guess that's what happens when you don't commentate forever. I'm sorry about that, by the way. Just life being life. Alright, so let's just go ahead and take care of that. And of course, we can use the cane apache to turn over the vase, and, or vase jar. I'm assuming it's a jar, but we can go up here, and it brings us to the top of this place. So we can go in here, and... Whoa, did you see that cat looking at me? I know it wants a piece of me. Yeah, so the cat will go at you. We don't have a ladder. Shaking the bookcase won't make it fall. This presents an interesting problem, wouldn't you say? No. No, it doesn't. Yeah, the cat will kind of swipe at you. So, just be careful. It does, like, I think a quarter HP or something. Something like that. Let's see, actually. Let's see. Ow. Rawr, would you like to fuse kinstone? Rawr. I know you tried killing me, but let's fuse kinstones. Let's see. What does Scratcher the Cat? That is a wonderful name. Alright, what do we get out of this? A treasure chest! Alright. In the Lon Lon Ranch, actually. They fit perfectly, per. Except, even though you fuse kinstones, he still kind of wants to kill you. So, that's just a slight bit awkward, but whatever the case, we can now go ahead and get the book. Alright. So, let's just go ahead and head next door, and aw, he's just a normal kitty cat. Meowie meow! Meowie meow! And we got a library book called the Hylian Bestiary, or a Hylian Bestiary. Alright, dear mom, I'll be next door if you need me.
Yeah. I'll be next door getting my link on, my Triforce on. I'm going to be...
You know, I can't really actually think of that many innuendos. Maybe that's something you guys can do for me. Think of some Legend of Zelda innuendos. Like, or just bad pickup lines, like, baby, I knew, baby, you complete my last heart container. Or, you're the last piece of heart I need. Whatever. I'm just terrible at this. I'm drawing absolute blanks. The next overdue book is, let's see. Oh yes, of course. Legend of the Picori. It's been out forever. It was checked out by a somewhat absent-minded scholar, I believe. Well, the absent-minded scholar is actually in this town, so that makes our lives so much easier. However, what we have to do is, once again, empty bottle. Yeah. Alright. So let's go ahead and head on over to where the empty scholar would be, which is over here, actually. So we can cross the bridge. No, we can't. I'm a liar. You can only cross that bridge as a Picori, funny enough. Alright, well... That's fine. Okay, we're back. Again, I'm so sorry. I messed up the order of sequence. When you do something 1,000 times, it just kind of blends together. What we have to do is we're here in the coffee shop, right? And so we got to once again take the cane apache and turn into the size of a Minish. And as you can see to the bottom left over here, there is an exit that we can go ahead and take, and yeah, I was going the right way, I just wasn't thinking properly. Anyway, we have to go ahead and clear that, and we get to go ahead and talk to this dog. Sorry I'm in your way, but trust me, there's an explanation here. I'll get out of your way soon. Sorry. Ruff. And nobody even bothered to ask why I was blocking the way for so long. The people here are so polite, but they lack backbone, you know what I mean? Let's fuse Kinstones, and let's see what Growler the Puppy gives us. Which, I don't know about you guys, I have to actively resist, like, whenever I see a dog, no matter what dog it is, I have to actively resist going up to it to be like, Puppy! I'm a dork that way, guys. I am. I am such a dog person and a cat person. I just love animals, right? But unfortunately, like, my mom doesn't like dogs, so I never got a pet growing up. Like, I think a lot of it was when I was growing up, they assumed that all the responsibility would be foisted onto them, which is not true in my defense. I don't think that would be true. I think I would honestly have loved that thing, but yeah, whatever. One day, it is actually, like, a dream of mine. I don't have many dreams/ambitions, but it is a dream of mine to, like, have a pet. Which is really funny, because, like, all my friends have pets, and I'm, like, fantastic with all of their pets, except for one of my friends has a chow? Yeah, a chow, which, supposedly, chows have a horrendous reputation for being just bad. It's half chow, so... Yeah, we don't really hang out at his friend's house anymore. Huh. Anyway, let's talk to the scholar, and I'm a researcher of Picori legend and lore. My name is Dr. Left.
What happened to Dr. Right?
You heard about that book, Legend of Picori, aren't you? Well, I hate to say it, but I haven't seen it in several days. Perhaps a mischievous little mouse has taken it. Well, I'm sure it's in this house somewhere, I just don't know where. But I'm very busy right now, so why don't you look for it yourself? Okay, something I forgot to do this time around is that, once again, we have to take out that fire. Go into this house, right? And we go into... This is the carpenter's house. And we shrink down to the size of the Minish, right? So then what we do is go through here. Once we've gone through here, we can go into here, which is, of course, the absent-minded scholar's house. However, we do not actually need to push this in quite yet, even though this is where the thing is. We talk to this Minish right here. Hey, do you know the clues that reveal the location of the treasure? Cross the bridge that spans the rapid flow, through the land of the fearsome beast, until you reach the Misty Falls. The treasure sleeps on the other side of the secret entrance there. They say it's a magical tool that allows even little people to push big things. According to the legend, you're supposed to start from this house. Start from this house indeed. So what we do is actually go into the fireplace here. I kept tricking myself up, and let's see, let's go into here, and I really like this house. This is the best place in the human town. I want to stay here forever. Let's see if we can't fuse Kinstones with him. We don't have to, this isn't part of it, but eh, why not? Town Minish. I wish they gave the Minish their own names too. Like, Bob. Bob the Minish. Well, there is another lily pad that takes us to that crack, so that's pretty good. So we'll check that out later. So then what we do is we go into this place here, right? And ooh, look, there's a Minish. Hey, I've heard about you, so you're gonna go ahead, aren't you? Well, onward to glory then, just don't die out there, okay? Alright. So then what we do is go over here, right? We cross this bridge. And then, let's talk to this Minish. Oof, it's no good. I can't get anywhere, man oh man. Yeah, it's kind of rough. So then we have to make our way past these two cats, which are the fearsome beasts. And they do a little bit of damage. They do like a heart and a half, which, could be worse. And then we go into this little cave. Who knew that there was a place like this behind the town water pump? Well, maybe we should get moving and find that Minish treasure. Yes. So we gotta use the Minish treasure in here to get the second book. So that's why I kept getting tripped up. I kept thinking that we could do the second book and that this treasure is afterwards. So yeah. Alright. Let's go over here to the right and take care of these. I am going to make my life a significantly bit easier and just do that. And stun them for a brief period of time, and go ahead and destroy these pots, which not really needed, but hey, whatever. We will now use the Cane of Pachi to go up here. And there are 4 ladybugs, which, again, just use with the Minish, or the Minish, use with the boomerang. I almost called it a butterfly. Man, I cannot speak today. Alright, let's go ahead and finish them off. This is a kind of a long approach, but you know what? I'd say it's worth it, because it just kind of takes care of them and you don't lose any damage or anything. You got the power bracelets. You're filled with strength even while tiny. Alright. So now we can go to the absent-minded scholar's place, and now we can push his little bookcase thing back. Alright, so I will meet you guys there. Alright guys, so we're back here in the absent-minded scholar's place, and now we can push the bookshelf with no problem whatsoever. So what we're gonna do now is go up here and mess up everything. No, what we have to do, I was tricking you guys to make sure you guys were paying attention. We push this bookshelf in first and push that all the way there. No, it just wouldn't let me go down without accidentally pushing that. Then we do this, then we push it in. Gosh, I am just so on top of my game today, aren't I, guys? Alright, let's go ahead and grab our gust jar and blow away some of the smoke. And we have to do that for all of these, because, ooh, look at that. One of those things is revealed. And let's just go ahead and push away those. And if we talk to this one, ho, ha, hey, phew, I want to return this book by dropping it down below. It's impossible without some help pushing. But my brother is so busy with a book of his own, he won't help me out. Maybe I can do it with one more push. Alright, so what we have to do is split up into 2 links. Unfortunately, we couldn't be a third, but what do you have to say, actually? I see. Oh, that makes sense. Human books are so interesting. And that guy, Mr. Left, Dr. Left, living down there has great taste in reading material. That's always good to know. What do you have to say? Thanks for cleaning up. Now all the dust is gone. All the dust is gone! Which is a wonderful feeling, isn't it? Like, I hate cleaning as much as the next guy, but every once in a while, I'll just get into, like, a cleaning frenzy, right? And I'll just clean, and it's just such a wonderful feeling of being able to see the floor. But, yeah, you just take double links and you fall! But you take no damage. Because, you know, we're too awesome to take damage, guys. I mean, let's be honest. Alright, so what we have to do is just go ahead and head back into where the carpenters were, which is over here, and let's go ahead and go back to normal size. Yeah, and actually let's talk to the carpenter and fuse kinstones with him, shall we? All right, and this is the last one of our type, so I don't see kinstone fusing occurring in our near future. Let's see what pops up over here. Ooh, a golden snake. So that's gonna drop, I believe, 50 rupees. 50 or 100 rupees. Quite a bit of rupees, so let's drown! Alright, let's go over here and pick up the book! You got a library book called The Legend of the Picori. Alright, so let's go ahead and return this to the library. We are Link the Librarian! Alright. Oh my goodness, will you look at that? It's our copy of The Legend of Picori. It's been checked out for so long. Link, you deserve a medal for all this. I move, deeply, deeply moved by this thoughtful gesture. Apparently, anytime anyone in Hyrule gets an item, they just hold it up over their heads. That's like a Hylian custom. The last book we need is A History of Masks. I think it was checked out by Hagen, the mayor. How could he keep a library book for so long? He's a public official.